Meet Bachelorette Claire Crawley. Bachelor franchise fans were delighted in March 2020 when Crawley was officially made the lead for the show's 16th season. But how did she go from being a 2014 runner-up to being named the Bachelorette 6 years later? Unlike most bachelorettes, who usually only have a season's worth of bachelor experience under their belts, Claire Crawley is entering her search for true love as a seasoned veteran of the franchise. Hailing from Sacramento, California, Crawley was first introduced to Bachelor Nation in 2014, when she appeared as a contestant on Juan Pablo Galavis' season of The Bachelor. Although Galavis ultimately rejected Crawley for Nikki Farrell, Crawley became an instant fan favorite, securing her spot on the very first season of the hit spin-off Bachelor in Paradise. After leaving that season of Paradise during the fifth week, Crawley was invited to return to the show for its second season. Unfortunately, she didn't end up finding love on the beach, eventually getting eliminated again during the third week. However, her journey wasn't over yet. The hairstylist took another chance on reality TV Love in February 2018, appearing as a contestant on The Bachelor Winter Games. Crawley didn't have luck finding her forever love on the Olympics-themed spin-off either. As a contestant on season 18 of The Bachelor, Crawley accepted a rose from Juan Pablo Galavis week after week, eventually becoming one of the final two women left standing at the end of his season. However, her relationship with Galavis throughout the course of the season was fraught with drama. So, when Galavis ultimately rejected Crawley during his final rose ceremony, the usually polite, softly spoken hairstylist had some choice words for the former soccer pro. Upset that Galavis waited until the last minute to break up with her instead of letting her go sooner, she said, "I lost respect for you. I thought I knew what kind of man you were. What you just made me go through, I would never want my children having a father like you." Considering Galavis is widely considered to be one of the least liked bachelors in franchise history, Crawley's breakup speech was instantly iconic and a total home run with fans. The Bachelor Winter Games saw Claire Crawley form romantic connections with two men. Canadian contestant Benoît Beausejour-Sauvage and Germany native Christian Rauch. While fans were rooting for Crawley to end up with Benoît, she ultimately rejected the fan-favorite contestant for Rauch. Unfortunately, Crawley and Rauch's Winter Games relationship didn't play out the way the franchise veteran had hoped, and Crawley left the show and headed back to Sacramento a single woman. However, after leaving the show, Crawley reconnected with Benoît over the phone. He told People, "We spent hours and hours each and every day talking to each other." In fact, Crawley and Beausejour-Sauvage's connection was so strong that the Canadian contestant proposed to Crawley during the Bachelor Winter Games World Tells All special. While Crawley gleefully accepted his proposal, the engagement didn't last long. The pair announced their split on Instagram in April 2018, telling fans there were no negative feelings. They wrote, "We are simply two people who believed in love and were open enough to give it a chance." The Bachelor franchise is known for its tendency to splice and dice clips to create a made-for-reality TV narrative, no matter how far from reality that narrative might be. Crawley knows all too well what it's like to be at the mercy of the production and editing teams. During the very first season of Bachelor in Paradise, Crawley found herself at odds with fellow Paradise castmate Ashley Frazier. During one unforgettable moment, Crawley sobbed and vented to a producer about her argument with Frazier. However, the entire conversation was edited to look as if Crawley was confiding in a raccoon. Yes, you can add this to the reasons that The Bachelor is totally fake. In a February 2017 appearance on the Steve Carbone's Reality Steve podcast, Crawley said she'd been approached by fans who genuinely believed she'd held a full-on conversation with a raccoon. She said, "I would have rather talked to a raccoon. I was talking to one of the producers. I didn't even know there was a raccoon there." Featuring pilot Peter Weber in the leading role, season 24 of The Bachelor was criticized for the way it placed its focus on creating drama between the contestants rather than on Weber's supposed search for long-lasting love. Particularly, the shockingly young ages of the contestants left viewers feeling as if The Bachelor had become a show about young 20-somethings gaining an Instagram following and pursuing their social media influencer aspirations. By announcing Claire Crawley as the Bachelorette for the show's 16th season, franchise producers seemed to send a clear intentional message that it was time to return to the show's roots. Crawley, 38 years old at the time she was crowned, is a welcome departure from previous younger leads, who likely could have used a few more years of relationship experience before trying to find a spouse.
For me, it just is more years under my belt, more learning and knowing what I want, what I don't want, and what I won't settle for.
Speaking during her official Bachelorette announcement on March 2nd, 2020, Crawley said, "I feel so much younger at heart than my actual age. I'm proud of my age, but I just feel younger." While appearing on The Bachelor is pretty much a guarantee you'll be getting paid to promote Fab Fit Fun boxes within a matter of months, Crawley's Bachelor Nation debut happened at a time in which social media wasn't nearly as big as it is today. So instead of becoming an Instagram influencer after being rejected by Juan Pablo Galaviz, Crawley returned to her career as a hairstylist. Even after multiple appearances on Bachelor spin-off shows, the California native has remained committed to making other people feel beautiful as a hairstylist at De Facto Salon in East Sacramento. In a May 2019 Instagram post, Crawley said her favorite part about being a hairstylist is making connections with her clients along the way. Captioning a picture of herself and a smiling customer, Crawley wrote, "I specifically remember one of my beauty school teachers telling me I'd never be successful because I care too much what the client thinks. Well, here we are, years later, and I'm still obsessed with my job and surrounded by some of the most amazing clients and friends ever." While Crawley went on to solidify her place within the Bachelor Nation books with her appearances on Bachelor in Paradise and The Bachelor Winter Games, fans were left wondering why she wasn't chosen for the Bachelorette role she so deserved following Juan Pablo Galaviz's disastrous season. During an October 2018 appearance on the Olivia Caridi's Mouthing Off podcast, Crawley opened up about why she wasn't named Bachelorette after her split with Galaviz. Speaking with Caridi, Crawley revealed that she'd talked to producers about becoming the Bachelorette and had even gone through the interview process. However, her mother was sick at the time, and she simply wasn't in the right emotional states to lead her own season of The Bachelorette. Speaking again with Caridi on Mouthing Off, Crawley revealed what the perfect relationship for her life would ideally look like. She said, "For me, a relationship that I would settle into and be happy to be a part of would be with somebody who is very self-confident in themselves. I have learned and taught myself how to create my own happiness, so I don't need a man for happiness. I've created a life that I love. I've created a life that I'm absolutely obsessed with, and it will take a lot for a man to kind of come in that." However, while Crawley definitely doesn't need a man to be happy with her life, she does have an idea of the type of guy who would make her perfect mate, saying, "I want him to be able to add value to my life. I want a man that can get me out of my comfort zone." Before Crawley's surprise engagement to Benoit, she had talked to her former Canadian beau about the idea of capturing an engagement on film so that her mother could see and feel Crawley's excitement. In an October 2018 episode of Mouthing Off with Olivia Caridi, she said, "My mum has Alzheimer's and dementia. For her to be able to watch that back would be beautiful, I think." In an Instagram post on January 13, 2020, Crawley opened up about how deeply she'd been affected by her mother's diagnosis. Revealing to followers her difficult journey to finding hard-earned happiness in her life, Crawley wrote, "2019 was awful tough. I don't show it often, but there were so many days where I wanted to just crumble. My chosen family and two sisters fought right alongside me when I was struggling, and I am forever, forever grateful. They held me up when the weight of my mum's diagnosis crushed my soul." The Bachelor franchise is known for planning extravagant, romantic, and sometimes downright terrifying dates for leads and contestants. Whether it's skydiving, eating bugs, naked bungee jumping, riding in helicopters, or being serenaded by country music artists that happen to be a contestant's ex-boyfriend, ABC's reality dating show has seen and done it all. Hopefully, the guys on Claire Crawley's season of The Bachelorette consider themselves to be outdoorsy types, because Crawley is a known nature lover. Just one look at her Instagram, and it's clear Crawley would rather be adventuring outdoors surrounded by nature than just about anywhere else. In a May 2018 Instagram post, she wrote, "Higher elevations always manage to cleanse my lungs and my soul all in one." Alongside another Instagram photo, Crawley wrote, "My body and the foggy weather was telling me to stay in my cozy bed and watch Netflix all day, but my soul was craving fresh air. Needless to say, I don't regret my decision." During her intro video for Juan Pablo Galaviz's season of The Bachelor, Crawley opened up about the most important man in her life, her late father. Recounting her father's tragic passing from brain cancer, Crawley said, "When my dad passed away, I feel like it just shattered my world because I was his baby girl." Crawley said that before her father passed away, her dad made a DVD for her future husband to watch. Nobody has ever watched it because Crawley is saving it for the right man. Between her dramatic relationship with Juan Pablo Galaviz, her failed appearances on Bachelor in Paradise, and her disastrous love triangle and eventual broken engagement from the Bachelor Winter Games, one might think Crawley would go back in time and change a thing or two. However, she's not one to harbor regret. Following her highly publicized split with Galaviz, Crawley spoke with Good Morning America in March 2014.
"The greatest thing is that I have zero regrets,"
adding, "I went into this feeling I'm going to be 100% open, and I'm going to be 100% myself, and I'm going to think about what I do, and because I thought and then acted, I'm proud of that." In a March 2015 Instagram post, Crawley echoed this sentiment, writing, "When someone asks me, 'So, do you regret going on The Bachelor?' my answer has and always will be the same. Not for a second." In a September 2017 Reality Steve podcast interview, Crawley opened up to host Steve Carbone about her dating history, revealing that she'd actually been romantically involved with another person or people from the Bachelor franchise, aside from Juan Pablo Galaviz. However, exactly who she's dated will likely always remain a secret, as the reality star admittedly prefers to keep her relationships private, saying, "I really don't put my dating life at all on my social media. I do like to keep it all private. In real life, in my regular life, I can be very introverted. I have a very peaceful, calm life. I actually really, really like my private life to be private. So for somebody whose motives are to try and get followers or to be part of the crew or part of the franchise, it's kind of not what I want to be involved in." You heard it here first. Claire Crawley has no time for aspiring Instagram celebrities. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite reality celebrities are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.